more better or stronger feng shui effect. That's why some of the developers, they may also check up the price for houses facing to the south. Because Malaysia and Singapore as well, our weather is quite hot. Most of the time, the developer prefers to build houses facing to the north or the south. Nowadays, very seldom people want to buy houses facing to the west because it's too hot. And is that correct? Actually, it's not true. Other directions also good. South also okay, north also okay, other directions. So long the external factor will not have the thing that I'm going to explain here should be okay. And some people may also read from books, West group people, West group person, and also East group. What is West group, East group? This is actually based on a chart. Based on the chart, based on the year of birth, or maybe the month of birth of the person, male or female, they are so-called luckier or lucky direction. Some, right, the West group person will be having so-called better luck facing to the West. The other group may be facing to the North or to the East. In such a case, nowadays, so many property developers, mostly they are building their houses right facing to the south and also the north. How to base on this? Actually, this is not so important also. This is very basic, but not the only one thing that we need to follow. However, this one, for example, for the neighbor's office facing direction is okay. But for the house selection, actually, we should not base on this one. Actually, this is a bit misleading. A lot of people, they come to me, they ask, okay, my house is facing to the south, and I'm a West group person, my wife is a West group person, how? Are we going to have bad luck and so on? Not to worry too much about this. And if your house that you are having, or you're going to buy, having this thing, water hydrant, do you think it's good or bad? Bad. Actually, it's good. Money is money, right? And also safer, right? When it comes to fire. Actually, it's correct. This is actually it's good. Either it's on the left or on the right. So when you're having this one, it's an added advantage. You can sell it many thousands more or higher.
But if it's
a
Shabazz
pipe?
Shabazz? Just a pipe,
Shabazz
pipe.
How does it look like?
You know, like
the
main meter,
but it's Shabazz.
Very big one.
Maybe
about 10 inches.
Oh, the one is what? I cannot recall how it does it look like. Anyway, facing to this one, how? Always avoid. Not so good. According to the so-called scientific measurement, it won't affect health. However, from the feng shui viewpoint, in the future also very difficult we want to resell it, very difficult. At the side it's okay, in front try to avoid. And also how about this one? Also try to avoid telecom substations. If, let's say the house that you want to buy is facing externally, let's say having this kind of tree, look like what? Look like a monster, right? Try to avoid lah. And even worse still is this one. Look like what? Look like a naked lady.
Real one.
It's a real one. Yeah. I do not know how to draw this. All these small pictures.
Which place there? Which place?
I think near your house.
Chop off really, chop off really.
Okay, don't chop. Ask the developer to move to other places.
Oh, like that.
Or you choose another unit.
Cannot chop one.
Don't chop.
Don't
chop. Cut the life.
Oh, I see.
And a lot of people know that if you want to buy a house, right, try to avoid buying houses facing to what? Facing to the hospital, facing to the police station, facing to the temple, facing to the mosque, facing to the church, facing to the hospital, all these things, even to the prison, try to avoid. However, do you know that facing to the bridge also actually not so good? Why a white bridge? Can you recall back the black and white movies during 60s or 50s, when the mother-in-law scolded the daughter-in-law very fiercely? So the daughter-in-law will run to where? Run to the bridge, walking up and down, right? Still considering whether they want to jump down or not. Why bridge? Why the director, they want to purposely shoot the scenery and the bridge? Because according to the belief, in terms of feng shui or cultural belief, the bridge, the qi is not stable. When you're at the bridge, right, you're like, blur, don't know where to go. So houses facing the bridge usually we do not like. So when you have a very, very big bungalow, right, try not to create a bridge there. You want to create, put at the side, it's okay. Don't be in front. Some people, they purposely, in their big bungalow, right, they build a bridge, seeing a bridge actually is not so good. Okay? And a lot of time, we are lacking of time for doing exercise, no time to work out. So they take home landscaping as part of the exercise. So they plant a lot of trees, a lot of flower around or surrounding their houses. So from the Feng Shui viewpoint, there are basically four major love affair sectors. Do you know where they are? They're exactly the west, they're exactly east, exactly south and east, south and north. So these are the four major love affair sectors. Tao Hua Wei, Tou Hua Wei. Don't plant any of the colorful flowers. Greens, big leaves is okay. Colorful flowers, try to avoid. Even in the office also try to avoid. Otherwise, in the house maybe can create unnecessary third party or fourth party affair. if you are planning quietly, then you can. I will tell your wife. And in the factory, if you are having a lot of all this, right, and this location having a lot of flowers, all this, you may find that your staff, they are loving each other, no time to work. And some people, they like to trim the trees into different shapes. They want to try out their artistic mind, right? Artistic hand. So they trim into the shape, the trees, right? Looks like what? Looks like animal, looks like a girl, looks like a boy, looks like all this, and try to avoid trim it like this one, like a cone. This is bad. Bad for the eye, bad for the heart, bad for the blood circulation, and so can create a lot of what? A lot of quarrels among the family members. So try not to trim it into this kind of shape. What kind of shape it would be better? This one is the best. Renminbi, better. Okay, now we come to water. When talking about water, water is the highest level of Feng Shui implementation, because the water will be able to accumulate the qi. That's why water, when we come to the hotel, all this, even shopping mall, this is part one of the hotel, this is one of the very good Feng Shui design. Basically, a good Feng Shui design is a house or a building, either it's a commercial building or your own house, or a whole block of condominium, the back must be higher. This is having a backing, having the two arms to cover or to attract, take in the good qi. And then in front there should have water. The water should be moving, actively moving. This is considered good. See, water is very important. Water must be always in front. That is why most of the time, right, in a new housing development project, right, most of the units which is at the waterfront will be so easily faster. Simply because most people know that all these are surrounding the water, surrounding the pond, will be easier to accumulate greater qi or greater nobility. You know, even condominium, most of the developers try to build it facing to the river. Should there be any natural river there? Or facing to the pond, or they purposely create a pond there? Or mining pond? So by having these waterfront units, right, they can sell it even higher, the prices. Even some of the places without natural water, without river, without pond, right, without lake, they also create a water fountain there, a big one, outside the entrance of the project. That will also create the positive chi for the whole residence. This is actually one of the ways. Of course, where to put, how the water flow also, it matters. And when given a chance, you want to choose a piece of land for your own factory, your company, or your own bungalow in the future, you can choose on all these places. This can be a river, or this can be a road. Okay, we always prefer to choose which is located in the inner curve of the river or the road. This is better. The development in the future, the appreciation, everything will be faster comparing to this. For example, here you can see that this one seems like having more development, right, comparing to here. And water, slowly we are going into the house. The water, including what? The swimming pool, the water fountain, water feature, all this. A lot of people may ask, hey, where can we put, when shall we put the water feature? It must be on the left, according to some books. Water feature must be put on the left, because the left side, left means we are standing inside the house looking out. The left side is a dragon side, green dragon side. Dragon is good to put that. Correct or not? And then they say, right hand side cannot put water feature, because when we put the right hand side having water feature there, the wife will become very fierce. The husband become very limbic. Husband no energy, the wife become very fierce. Is that correct? Incorrect. Because I have been receiving a lot of these inquiries and some husband come and ask me, hey, I'm having a water feature on the right hand side and my wife become very fierce. Why are this, this and that? Is that because of that? No, actually it's not true. However, water fountain, don't simply put at home if you're not sure, right? Because the way the qi can be accumulated and can be triggered will be very fast. So when it's fast, right, it can trigger positively, the positive effect or negative effect also very fast. Okay, we also like to renovate our house when we come to home improvement. Yes?
Sorry, like say when you say put on the left hand side of the house, you have a double story house and then you have your following moon and your backing moon.
Oh, we always the left or right of the house, we are referring to the whole house. The whole house facing, but the gate is facing. So your main door can be facing here. So your left right is still referring to the whole house, not referring from your door.
The corner, left hand side.
Left is over here, right is over here. As if you are standing at the car wash looking out to the gate. The left is here, the dragon side. Yeah, this is the right side, the tiger side.
But say if on the left hand side is the place where you throw your rubbish,
The
left hand side is where the rubbish bin is. And then so you put your water fountain at that corner or you can put it at the front porch.
Okay, this slide actually presents, water fountain cannot simply based on the left hand side or right side, must be customized according to the family members' date and time of birth, all the family members, and also plus the direction of the house. Cannot depend on the person having the house facing to this one, having the rubbish bin is here, having a piece of empty land, and the one, then you put it there, cannot. Sometimes, that's why some people they may need to renovate their front portion in order to accommodate maybe some water feature there. We cannot. There isn't any standard rules. This house is facing here, then must be here. The house facing there must be there. Must be customized. This water tank must be customized. And there's no any generic rules. Okay, I hope I answered your question. Now we are talking about renovation and extending the house. Most of us, right, we like to extend because we do not like to maintain the small little garden at the back, right? So we extend, make full use of the space available. So try always try to maintain the rectangular shape of the house or the space. Try not to create something like this, or try not to purposely enlarge it something like this, or having a missing corner here. For example, because why? Because a more rectangular space, right, the distribution of the qi will be more even. Because the so-called flying star qi, it flies every year differently. Sometimes, for example, certain years, right, this place, the main door can be good, but next year can be bad. For example, over here, suddenly maybe a particular year, this qi located here is bad. So this one will contain more percentage of the negative qi. It will create more negative effect to the family member. Let's say in this example, right, this is a missing corner. So happen the positive chi is located here. Then this house will have less, can take in lesser positive chi. So we prefer to be more rectangular, the shape of the house, when we want to do renovation also. So the main door, a lot of people may say, it's very boring, having the main door, right, for the past 40, 50 years, 60 years, every day see the main door rectangular, very boring. So all part of the house has been renovated already in order to get a home improvement loan from OCBC. They say they want to change the door. Can we change to this side? No. Because why? This side of the door, when you open, you can see the sharp point, sharp edges, very bad. This one also try to avoid. And then also, moreover, a lot of people will try to avoid having this side of the door. You know why? Because it looks like what? When you go to Divana, then you can see this thing. The tombstone looks like a tombstone. And then, during holidays, right, in the last holidays, maybe the family went to where? Went to the Disneyland. So the kids like the room doors, like the doors very much. As they come back, requested the fathers or the parents, can we paint our main door to be like this so that every day we feel like going to Disneyland? No. Especially don't paint it to red color. It's a look like a temple. Don't paint it to like very strong yellow color, which are the earth and fire color. These are very bad because every year the flying star flies, right? When the negative chi arrives at the main door, that's where we are going in and out every day, many, many times. There will be, the negative chi will be even aggregated. So this one, never, never. And also, moreover, if you are having an enemy, right? Suddenly you do not know, you offended somebody, some people will identify, the bad guy are staying at the house. The red color door. Usually we try to avoid having the door too different, too unique, too outstanding, the door.
What about brown and white?
Brown is okay, white is okay, but not this sort of color. But blue color actually in the school usually have. Usually at home we usually use maybe white or those brownish colors, okay. And some people also read from books. Okay, they believe that the left side, the dragon side, right, must be bigger comparing to the right side. So they make it two leaf, one side is bigger than the other side. Actually, this is actually not very good. If possible, try to make it similar size, same size better. If your house or your office or your company is having this one, the door outside, there's a staircase going out. That means the chi is flowing out. The money cannot be accumulated. How to remedy this one? Change the direction to the house, the door. Hang and change, difficult. No need, actually. What you should do, you create a small little threshold, we call it 门槛, 1 inch high, put on the floor when you want to go in, right? You need to raise your leg. There's not like a small little threshold that will avoid the chi flowing out too much. And also avoid the dust going into your house also. And this type of door, usually not encouraged. I also try not to plant too much of all, or cannot plant any of the plant on top of the door also. This will be creating a lot of skin problem, a lot of health problem as well. Become very yin. And this type of shape of the door, where can you find out? Voodoo jail. Usually during the old ancient time, this type of shape of the door, right, is being built at the back of the big houses to let who to go in and out, let the slave go in and out. Remember, the main door usually is rectangular. Usually we don't use that, this type of door. This one, okay, about this, some also read from books. Okay, both husband and wife, they are doing very big businesses. However, husband and wife having different kwa number. So they create this door is for the wife, this door is for the husband. So you walk this door, I walk that door. Eventually, they don't talk to each other. Whether the husband come back or not, whether the wife come back or not, they also do not know. So no good, actually. This has become too superstitious already. Feng Shui implementation is not basing on that. So talking about color, right? Color is very important in terms of in our house, right? How to create the so-called the positive chi, and how to choose your right color, your lucky color, okay? Without consulting a feng shui master. This is a very important tip for you. The secret birth code basing on your birthday, you can know what are your lucky color. Because when we were born, right, that's what I explained just now, we will be charged by a set of very unique combination of five forces. In order to make our five, because some people you may hear that, or some people their stomach weaker, some their lung weaker, some bicep stronger, tricep weaker, all this, right? Because of the combination of forces in their body. So by understanding their life path, right? Of course, if you are able to get a feng shui master or fortune teller to tell you your eight character, your 八字, then they can tell you your lucky color are what, right? But if you don't feel comfortable seeing a feng shui master like this, you can actually basing on this. Well, but actually by understanding your life path, right, you can know which part of your body will be good, during what year you will be having greater wealth, and this and that. All this, I leave it as a secret birth code. And also by understanding this, you should also always, for example, I always wear green, inside out, green and red, green and also blue. So it will create a better luck to you. So, basing on this chart, actually you will know what are your lucky colors. For example, if you were born in the Western calendar, between February the 4th to May the 4th, you should use more matter and earth element related color, which are the white and silver, and also the yellow and also brown. If you were born between May the 5th to August the 7th, you should use more bluish color. If you were born between August the 8th to November the 7th, you should use more green color. November the 8th to February the 3rd, you should use more fiery color, the red color, purple and pink. How to use, you eat, not eat color. Okay, you should wear jewelries, or even your name card, okay? Your clothing, your website, all this you can use, you can make full use of all this. This is how we can, this is the way how we apply into our day-to-day life. For me, I use mainly dark green and blue, even my website, everything. And name card, try not to use black color. Some people, they use black color, actually not so good. And also, try not to have very funny shape. The signboard also, even the packaging, you can use. Even your car, you can also, based on that, to choose your lucky color. Based on your lucky color, you may find that some people dealing with sales, right? They find that after I change this car to this particular color, I find that my sales are going on very, very well. That is actually part of the so-called the color feng shui effect. This car is good for everyone. All in one. The best feng shui color. And even the numbers as well also matters. The numbers, if you look at my brochure, everything 8, right? Level 8, unit number 8. And numbers, how do you know your lucky numbers? Also similarly basing on this chart as well. For example, I'm having this number. This is my toll-free number. And basing on the similar theory as well. If you are born between February the 4th and May the 4th, you should use more matter and earth element. There'll be numbers relating, linking to all these elements. May the 5th to August the 7th, water, you can find from my website as well if you're unable to copy. And basing on this, right, number 3 and 4, numbers end with 3 or 4 at the end, right? Or you sum until the single digit is 3 or 4, it will be wood element. If your lucky element is wood element, you should use, for example, in terms of telephone number, in terms of your house number, right? Even branding, all these things you can use. This type of idea as well. 258 is earth element. Any number end with 6 or 7 is considered a matter element. Number 9 is fire element. Then number 1 is water element. This is the so-called the secret. If you want to apply 4D, you also kind of basing on this. And in terms of color, how do we decide what type of color to paint at different sectors of our life? One of the ways is very simple one, but this one, right, this idea, it wouldn't create any so-called positive feng shui effect, but it's very safe. For example, house faces to the north, right, you can use more bluish color or a little bit of white, then it's okay. And houses faces to the south, you can use a little bit of yellowish, but not too red color, or also a little bit of greenish color is okay. Or houses facing to the east, you can use a little bit of greenish color, the facing or the location of the sector. Then houses located or faces, house faces to the west, you can use a little bit of beige color or yellowish color or white color. This one is a very same kind of color application. However, it will not give you any very strong kind of function effect. The stronger function effects is must be having different combination, then it will create a different so-called effect.